Unlike all these other days, today we had the opportunity to pray together here at Dr. Ambrosio Memorial Church. And many churches are scared to allow me to pray with them, but I want to thank Father Esio and Father Raymond and the leadership of the church for allowing a humble Christian like me to come and pray together. God is good and all the time. My brothers and sisters, it is only God that can allow us to be here today. We have gone through a lot of trouble in the past days. We have gone through tear gas. We have gone through live bullets. We have gone through prison. Many of our brothers and sisters have been killed. Killed by the police and the military. Simply for standing for the truth. This is the first day that I'm having a campaign without wearing a bulletproof. The first day. And I am doing that because I just walked out of the church and I know that the blood of Jesus is with me now. And I want to remind all of you that if God is with us, nobody can stand against us. That is why we don't have any guns. We don't have any bullets. We don't have any knives or stones. But the people who have guns are very scared of us. So to the people of Kalongo and the people of Agago in general, allow me introduce myself once again. My name is Chagulanyi Sentamu Robert. Many of you know me as Bobby Wine. I have grown up in your face. It is the love of people like you that got me from the ghetto to where I am today. For a long time you have known me as a musician. But today I come to you with a very important message. It is a message of freedom. It is a message of liberation. When I look here, the majority of people are the youth, young people. And many of them don't know where we have been and how we got here. But the elders that are present here today will bear me witness that Kalongo has ever looked better than it looks now. Agago has ever been better than it is today. And Northern Uganda has ever been better and richer than it is today. But 35 years ago, a man called Museveni picked up guns with another group of rebels And they captured our country. And since then, he made all of us slaves in our own land. The reason why the police and the military has been stopping me from talking to people wherever I have been. It's because they know when I talk to you, your eyes will open. And you will know the truth. And you will become like Bobby Wine. And if we are many Bobby Wine and many Obedigus in Uganda, we can no longer be slaves. So my brothers and sisters, what we are telling you today, you are not going to hear it on radio. You are not going to hear it on TV. Because even the radios and TVs are used to make us blind. So that we don't know, so that we don't realize how powerful we are. Before I go any further, I want you to know that the most important weapon which somebody can use to make you a slave is your brain. And if you open your brain, if you free your mind, nobody can make you a slave. And that is why everybody that has tried to say what I say, they have either killed them or put them to prison. But this is a different generation. They will put Obedigu in prison. He will come out and say the same thing. They will put Bobby Wine in prison. He will come out and say the same thing. You know why? Because we are not scared. Because we don't fear. The bridge, the only curtain that stands between us and our freedom. It is called fear. And we, when we overcome our fear, when we lose our fear from Museveni, he will lose his power over us. So even if we have our elders here among us today, my message, I want it to go to the young people gathered here today. Because you are more than 90%. And you are the future of Kalongo. You are the future of Agago. You are the future of Uganda. And you are the future of Africa. And I want you to remember that all leaders that have changed the world, they have done that in their youthful days. Now, why am I standing to be a president? My brothers and sisters, I have told people wherever I go, and I want to tell the people of Agago today, that I am not here to represent the rich. I am not here to represent the powerful. I am here to represent the common people. I am here to represent the poor people. I am here to represent the young people. The old people who have struggled but their dreams have been betrayed. I am here to represent the ghetto people. I am here to represent the people of Uganda that have been excluded for 35 years. When you look around, you see a very beautiful country. Northern Uganda is gifted by nature. Agago is gifted by nature. Look at the beautiful hills. Look at the fertile land. Look at the rich land. Why are the people of Agago poor? Why are the people of Northern Uganda poor? That is because the leaders want you to be poor. Yes. You are poor. Listen. We are poor because Museveni made Uganda a property of himself and his family.
Yes.
That is why Acholi land is grabbed every day with impunity. All this mess that is happening is not a mistake. The cattle rustling is not a mistake. The bad roads is not a mistake. That is intended to keep you down so that they can govern you. We can go on and on and on and on about the problems that we have. But I come here not to talk about the past. Because Museveni belongs to the past. I'll say it again, Museveni belongs to the past. But he belongs to the future. Together we are the future. And what does the future look like? This is how the future looks like, my brother. Number one, we believe that all Ugandans should be equal before and under the law. We believe that all Ugandans should have equal opportunity regardless of their tribe or religion. But most importantly, we believe that all power belongs to the people of Uganda. And therefore, when you make me your president, brothers and sisters, I said, when you vote me to become your president, I am going to be your servant and not your boss. I say I will be a servant and not a boss. For the first time, the people of Uganda must be above the leaders. The politicians are supposed to be your servants. The politicians are supposed to be your servants. Tell them again. Because you're the ones that vote them in those positions of leader. And another thing I want to talk about, very briefly, because we have three districts to go to, ladies and gentlemen. I am aware about the bad roads because that is where we've passed. I I know that I am still looking clean because this is the first campaign I am attending today. But I know that at the end of the day, all this suit and shirt is going to be brown. Because of the bad roads. Wherever I pass, I see only poverty. Wherever you look, you only see schools that have been destroyed terribly. I know that your hospitals and health centers have no medicine whatsoever. I can go on and on about the problems. But in brief, as a summarize, let me talk about the solution. The solution is not Obedigiu Samia. The solution is not Chagulanyi here. The solution is you. I said the solution is you. How many people here are going to vote? So do you see all the hands that you see there? Those hands can change the life of our people in this district and in Uganda. So on the 14th of January, I want to encourage all of you, please come out in large numbers and vote. I said come out in large numbers and vote. When you go to vote, you are not going to see the name Bobby Wine on the ballot. You're going to see the name Chagulanyi Sentamu Robert. Tell your friend Chagulanyi Sentamu Robert. And you will see the symbol of an umbrella like this. So when you see that umbrella, just stick that umbrella. And not only me, but all the candidates that come with the umbrella, just stick that umbrella. My brothers and sisters, when you vote for that, you will be voting for new change. You will be voting for a new Uganda. You will be voting for change. You will be voting for better schools. For better hospitals. You will be voting for the end of land grabbing. You will be voting for the end of dictatorship. You will be voting for the end of gun power and the beginning of people power. I say it again, my brothers and sisters, your vote is very powerful. And what you do with your vote is going to decide which kind of road that young boy will walk on when he's 20 years. With your vote, you will be deciding where your wife is going to give birth from. So, brothers and sisters, as I conclude, let me also tell you this. After voting, please don't leave the polling station. Stay there and guard your vote. We have looked, we have moved all over the country, and the people, especially the young people, are searching for change, and I know we are going to achieve that change this time around. So don't leave it to us, please be involved. Be the Obedigu of this place. Be the Bobby Wine of this place. Uganda is our country. And we are the ones that are going to change it. And we have this opportunity that we must use. So brothers and sisters, let us use this opportunity and we will never regret. Let us go to the books of history. That in 2021, the young people of Uganda voted massively and they removed a dictator. Let it be remembered that the young people in 2021, by using their vote, they created security for their animals, for their cattle and all other farm animals. We can do that and we should do that for God and our country. And before I leave, allow me to read out the names of our candidates. Number one, we have Ochan Joseph. Ochan Joseph will be the area councillor LC5. We have Otto Vincent Onega, our chairperson, Aban Council, Patongo Trading Center.
One comment, Aban Council, Patongo Trading Center.
We have Oriema John Bush, our area councillor, LC5, Patongo Trading Center. We have Okello Samuel, our councillor, LC5, Patongo, Katomol sub-country, sub-county.
Councillor Pete Katomol.
That one. People power! Our power! We have Owini John. LC3. Kunywe sub-county. Kuye. People power! Our power! Yeah, we have a team. Fanelik. His name is like Italian. We have a team. Fanny Collins.
Yeah, man. You can win a team, Fanny Collins.
Our LC3 leader, Palwar.
One commander, maybe you're up and down.
Is that the right pronunciation? Yeah. We have Awichi Thomas.
Awichi Thomas.
That is our LC3 Katomol sub-country. We have Lugwar Benson. Is our district youth councillor, Kalongo Trading Center. Kalongo Town Council.
Kalongo Town Council.
Yeah, man. Please pardon the few mistakes that I make. We are going to be learning on the job. You are going to get a president who is your friend. We have Otim Julius. Otim Julius Nyerere.
Julius Nyerere.
Is our LC3 Omot sub-county.
one commander me about Sub County.
We have Ojala Phillips.
He's
our area councillor, Kalongo Town Council.
Area councillor, let alone.
We have Aloyo Grace.
Aloyo
Grace is our woman councillor, Lira Kato.
Yes,
Sub County.
Councillor from Mount Kato Sub County.
We have Okelo Tone. Is also our area councillor LC3. We have Ochen Bosco. Also area councillor 3.
Councillor Beck Mikoromo.
We have Akelo Rose.
Akelo Rose.
Woman councillor
LC3.
We have Abil Kala.
Abu Kala.
Her name is he's called Abul Kala. Yeah, woman councillor LC3. Also representing Kuye.
Yeah, Kuye. Yeah.
We have Otim Francis.
Otim Francis
Wokorach is area councillor 3.
Councillor Tech me Paton.
Okay, we have Otema Dennis. Otema Dennis, our area
councillor 3.
We have Uhuru Charles. We also have Okech James. Both these ones are area
councillors.
People power! Our power! We thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and we ask you that you permit us to proceed to the next district. We want to make sure we reach every district in Uganda and to deliver the message of freedom. Thank you very much. Apoyo Tutwar, Apoyo Matek. Now what do you want from me? What do you want now? You want music? I say we are fighting for. Okay, listen, yeah. We are living in a time similar to the one of slave trade. This operation is worse than apartheid. The gun is the master and the citizen slave. The pearl of Africa is bleeding. Question, what was the purpose of the liberation when we can't have a peaceful transition? What is the purpose of the constitution when the government disrespects the constitution? See what you're doing to our nation. What are you teaching the future generation? See our leaders become misleaders. See our mentors become tormentors. Freedom fighters become dictators. They look at the youth and say we are detractors. We are fighting for freedom. The people of Agago sing now. We are fighting for freedom. Listen to this one. Our people complaining night and day. They wonder why they continue to live this way. But I know that things can change someday. If you really vote, rise someday. Uganda land of abundance. But Ugandans living in deficiency. Museveni wants like president. So we must abandon that silly tendency. Uganda rich, but Ugandans poor, because Museveni is drunk on power. He runs the country like family affair.